Hey, good afternoon. This is another Black City Coffee blog. We are getting ready to roast with our new, brand new trial for Crema. So excited to roast this. We're doing Honduras today. We're just about ready to charge. Honduras is in. Check that out. There you go. I love this camera. One minute soak. So I think I've been going a little too gentle since I'm so, I think I roast a lot of naturals, and I'm in like a natural, gentler roasting mode. So I need to, what I'm going to try to do with this is roast a little bit more aggressively than I think I normally do with this profile, but I want to see if I can develop it a little bit more. Let's just see. I'm going to do this a little different. Looking for green and yellow right now. Still a little green. Ooh, it feels so good. Get over here if you could see that. Whoop. Whoa. Camera freaked out. All right. We're gonna almost call that yellow. Yep, that is yellow. We're at 5 minutes exactly. We got the runner here.
Sounds like
roasting with this guy. Roasting with the runner. Let's see how I can get a good angle on this. There you go. We can only do one roast today because I'm running out of battery, but that's enough. All right, so I've increased my air to about 75. And at around 6 minutes, I'm gonna come down a few. So far, I've been running basically max fuel. It's a little bit higher elevation beam, and it responds well to washed coffee, organic. Responds well to a typical roast. Easy to roast this time. Come down to 2.0 kPa at 6 minutes. The new dryer feels great with this new sort of door handle action that I have here. And it's lighter, so that's nice too. And it feels nicer. It just feels nicer on the hands because it's so smooth. And I just put a pinch of stain on there so I could see all of the wood grain. And it's so beautiful. And the brand looks dope too, doesn't it? I mean, you've seen it upside down, but when I turn it this way, it looks pretty dope. I'm down to 1.5 kPa at around 7 minutes. So like I said, I'm going just a smidge more aggressive than I normally do. That's also too because it's the first roast out of the gate. So in my mind, I'm making all of these rationalizations of why I'm doing these things. Around 7:30, I'm gonna come down to 1 kPa. I'll probably ride that out for a minute. I've heard some outlier cracks, but I feel that's pretty too early to increase the air. Sorry about the audio if you can't hear me that well. I didn't charge the microphone, so sometimes I'm not thinking so much about making the content, but making good coffee. Making good coffee comes first, content second, honestly. That's a good outlier crack to increase the air signal for myself. I'm like a medium high. It's a 350 alarm. Okay, we got a rolling first crack. And we're at 8 minutes 29. See? Easy. Perfect. That's a really good start. So, it's funny that I don't really take a lot of notes. I take a lot of mental notes. I'd love to take more physical notes, but I'm not really good at it. But I really like the idea of intuitional roasting, and yeah, I'm not ever gonna be a commercial roaster that's gonna roast everything to the T every single time. It'll just be whatever my experiences was in that moment, and that may not sound good to say like a big production roaster like Starbucks or a commercial roaster, but the fact that I'm small, artisan, by myself, doing everything myself, it kind of makes sense to do it that way, and I think for myself, I'm proud of that. I'm proud that every batch will just taste a little different and will capture whatever happened on that day. That's kind of cool. But as always, make sure the coffee just tastes good. So we've been riding 1 kPa at almost 10 minutes now. We're going to drop around 11, maybe 30, something like that. I want to go to a medium on this for this customer. We're on full air. The butterfly valve is closed, but we are getting a smidge of smoke feedback. But it's negligible, I'd say. I don't know if you could see it on the camera. There, we hit 10:30. Typically, I would drop this if it was a light roast. But I'm looking at the beans, too, and they have not yet developed to the point that I want them to. So we're going to go for it. Keep riding this out. Maybe 11:30, maybe it looks like. That will drop. Let's give it a little sniff. Great acidity coming off. Bean temp of like 400, so we're at 398 right now. So maybe we're gonna drop it like 1230 or something. Alright, we're getting there. The beans are looking good, a little swelled on the surface there. Feels awesome. Yeah. All right. Good things. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.